Hi everyone, I'm Lab Loy Chung from the National Center for Research on Earthquake Engineering and from the Departments of Civil Engineering, National Taiwan University and National Cheng Kung University. This is my name in Chinese, Zhong Li Lai. Welcome to the course Introduction to Seismic Design of Structures. This is Lecture 14-1. Damping modification for spectrum. In previous lecture, the damping ratio of the structure is fixed to be 5% so that we can construct design basis spectrum and maximum considered spectrum to be a function of only the structural vibration period, T. But the structure, the damping ratio of the structure may not be 5%. For example, for steel structure, the damping ratio may be less than 5%. And after the structure implemented with extra dampers, the damping ratio may be higher than 5%. Therefore, if the damping ratio is different from 5%, the design spectrum, design basis spectrum, and maximum considered spectrum must be modified. In this course, in this lecture, we'll talk about the damping modification for spectrum if the damping ratio is different from 5%. And here are some terminology. Damping modification factors. In Chinese, 阻尼修正系数 is the damping ratio is different from 5%. We have to use damping modification factor to modify those design spectra. And there are two damping modification factors. One is damping modification factor for short period structure. In Chinese, 短周期阻尼修正系数. The other is damping modification factor for 1 second period structure. In Chinese, 一秒周期阻尼修正系数. We use 1 second period to represent medium to long period range of the structure. Because of the damping of structure, energy can be dissipated during excitation. Therefore, the structural responses, including absolute acceleration, reduces due to the damping of the structure. In general, the higher the damping, the more the energy dissipated, and the lower the structural responses, including absolute acceleration. Then, the smaller the seismic force. The higher the damping ratio, the lower the spectral acceleration, and also the lower the seismic force. If the damping ratio is different from 5%, for short period structure, we have damping modification factor for design spectrum is 1 divided by BS. For 1 second period structure, the design spectrum will be modified by the damping modification factor 1 over B1. And BS is the damping modification factor for design spectrum for short period structure. And B1 is the damping modification factor of the design spectrum for 1 second period structure. And this information is taken from the Seismic Design Course Section 3.2. And here's the table, shows the damping modification factors BS and B1. And we found that the larger the damping ratio, the larger the damping factor, damping modification factor BS and B1. When the damping ratio is 5%, BS equal to 1, B1 equal to 1. That means that there's no modification for the design spectrum. If the damping ratio is less than 5%, BS and B1 is less than 1, and 1 over BS and 1 over B1 is larger than 1, Therefore, the desired spectrum will be amplified. If the damping ratio is larger than 5%, Bs and B1 is larger than 1, and the reciprocal of Bs and B1 is less than 1. Therefore, the desired spectrum will be reduced. If the damping ratio is not stated in this column, a linear interpolation can be applied. For example, if the damping ratio lies between 5% and 10%, then we use linear interpolation to find the values of Bs and B1. And the table is taken from the seismic design course, table 3.1. The larger the damping ratio, the larger the damping modification factor Bs and B1. If damping ratio is equal to 5%, then the modification factors for short periods, Bs, and for 1 second period, structure, B1, are 1. Therefore, the design spectrum will not be modified. When the damping ratio is equal to 5%, Bs equal to 1, and B1 equal to 1. If the damping ratio is less than 5%, then the modification factor, Bs, is less than 1, and the modification factor B1 is also less than 1, and the design spectrum will be scaled up. If the damping ratio is higher than 5%, then the modification factor Bs is larger than 1, and B1 is also larger than 1, then the design spectrum will be scaled down. And from our seismic design course table 2-5A, we can have the design basis spectral acceleration for site class 1, 2, or 3. And the design basis spectral acceleration is specified by two parameters. One is SDS, the other is SD1. And SDS and SD1 are determined by three factors. One is the location of the site, the fault distance of the site from the active fault, and also the site classification, whether it's a hard site or soft site. And T0D is the corner period between short period and medium to long period, equal to SD1 divided by S. From T0D, we can divide the design basis spectral acceleration into four segments. Since the damping ratio is fixed to be 5%, therefore the design basis spectral acceleration is the function of only fundamental vibration period T. If the damping ratio is different from 5%, from seismic design course table 3.2, we can have the design basis spectral acceleration for site class 1, 2, or 3. And from this equation for the design basis spectral acceleration, it can be found out that SDS is replaced by SDS divided by BS, and SD1 is modified to be SD1 divided by B1, and T0D equal to SD1 divided by SDS is substituted by T0 parenthesis D equal to SD1 times BS divided by SDS B1. According to T0D, the design spectral acceleration for damping ratio other than 5% can be also divided into four segments. In the first segment, from 0 to 0.2 T0 parenthesis D, it increases from 0.4 SDS to SDS divided by BS. In the second segment, the spectral acceleration is constant to be SDS divided by BS. In the third segment, the spectral acceleration decreases and inversely proportional to the structural vibration period T, and equal to SD1 divided by B1 T. And in the fourth segment is the lower bound for the spectral acceleration, and equal to 0.4 SDS divided by BS. When the structural damping ratio equal to 5%, BS equal to 1, B1 equal to 1. Therefore, there's no modification for SDS, no modification for SD1. Similarly, for T0, parenthesis D, BS equal to 1, B1 equal to 1 when the damping ratio equal to 5%. Therefore, there's no modification for T0 parenthesis D. Therefore, this equation reduces to the previous one for the damping ratio equal to 5%. Therefore, damping ratio equal to 5% is just a special case for this general term. Therefore, when the damping ratio equal to 5%, BS is assigned to be 1, B1 equal to 1, and the general equation can be reduced to the special equation for the damping ratio equal to 5%. And there's one more observation here. No matter what the damping ratio is, the EPA effective peak ground acceleration always equal to 0.4 SDS. It has nothing to do with the damping ratio. And back to the example, the site located at Yuishui Township, Hualien County. The question is to find design basis spectral acceleration of the site for damping ratio 2%, 5%, 10%, 20%, and 40%. There's a, what is SAD? What's the value for SAD? From previous lecture, we already have some information about this example. SDS equal to 1.136, SD1 equal to 0.711, T0D equal to SD1 divided by SDS equal to 0.626 seconds. And from previous line, we can construct the design basis spectral acceleration for different damping ratio by two parameters. One is BS, the damping modification factor for short period structure. The other is B1, the damping modification factor for 1 second period structure. And the spectral acceleration can be divided into four segments by the corner period between short period and medium to long period, T0 parenthesis D equal to SD1 times BS divided by SDS divided by B1. And here's the table. And in the first column is the damping ratio of the structure. It varies from 2% to 40%. And this is the column for the damping modification factor for short period structure, BS. As the damping ratio increases, BS increases also. And it's also true for B1. As the damping ratio increases, B1 increases. And the column here is SDS divided by BS. And then SD1 divided by B1. And then T0 parenthesis D is the corner period between short period and medium period. And as the damping ratio increases, BS and B1 also increases. But SDS divided by BS decreases, SD1 divided by B1 decreases, and T0 parenthesis D increases with the damping ratio. Once we have those parameters, SDS, SD1, BS, and B1, then we can construct the design basis spectral acceleration for various damping ratio. And here is the spectral acceleration for damping ratio 2%, and then 5%, and then 10%, 20%, and 40%. And from the graphs here, as the damping ratio increases, the damping modification factor BS and B1 also increases. But the spectral acceleration decreases. And this is 5%, the largest one, and then for 5% is lower, and then 10%, 20%, and 40%. And for the damping ratio with 40%, it has the lowest spectral acceleration for all these 5 cases. And we can observe that the EPA, the effective peak ground acceleration, remain the same no matter what the damping ratio is. Therefore, it has nothing to do with the damping ratio. The peak ground acceleration of the effective peak ground acceleration remains the same for various damping ratio. And then we move to design basis spectrum for Taipei Basin. From seismic design codes, table 2-7A, if the damping ratio of the structure is fixed to be 5%, then the design spectral acceleration for Taipei Basin is determined by two parameters. One is SDS, the other is TZOD. And according to TZOD, the spectral acceleration can be divided into 4 segments. Linearly increasing, constant, decreases, and inversely proportional to the structural vibration period, and also the lower bound. If the damping ratio is different from 5%, then from the seismic design codes table 3-3, then we can have the design basis spectral acceleration for Taipei Basin with damping ratio other than 5%. And SDS is changed to be SDS divided by BS. And T0D is changed to T0 parenthesis D equal to T0D times BS divided by B1. According to T0 parenthesis T0 parenthesis D, the spectral acceleration for Taipei Basin can be divided into 4 segments. In the first segment, it increases from 0.4 SDS to SDS divided by BS. In the second segment, it is constant to be SDS divided by BS. In the third segment, the spectral acceleration decreases and inversely proportional to the structural vibration period T equal to SDS times T0 parenthesis D divided by BST. In the fourth segment, is the lower bound for the spectral acceleration equal to 0.4 times SDS divided by BS. And there's one observation here. The effective ground acceleration EPA is always fixed to be 0.4 SDS. It does not change with the damping ratio. Therefore, it has nothing to do with the damping ratio. It is fixed for different damping ratio. When the damping ratio equal to 5%, BS equal to 1, therefore there is no modification for SDS. B1 also equal to 1, there is no modification for the corner period T0D. And this equation is reduced to the previous one here. Therefore, damping ratio 5% is just a special case for this general expression. Then we move to maximum considered spectrum for site class 1, 2, or 3. According to seismic design codes table 2-5B, then we have the maximum considered spectral acceleration if the damping ratio is fixed to be 5%. Therefore, the maximum considered spectral acceleration is just a function of the structural vibration period T. And the maximum considered spectral acceleration is determined by two parameters. One is SMS, the other is SM1. And these two parameters are determined by the location of the site, the distance of the site from the active force, and also the site classification, site class 1, 2, or 3. And TCOM is the corner period between short period and medium to long period, equal to SM1 divided by SMS. Therefore, in order to describe the maximum considered special acceleration, there's only two independent parameters, SMS and SM1. If the damping ratio is different from 5%, then according to the seismic design code table 3-1, we can have this maximum considered spectral acceleration with damping ratio different from 5%. And SMS is modified to be SMS divided by BS, and SM1 is modified to be SM1 divided by B1, and T0M is modified to be T0 parenthesis M equal to SM1 BS divided by SMS B1. And according to T0 parenthesis M, we can divide the maximum considered spectral acceleration into four segments. In the first segment, the spectral acceleration increases from 0.4 SMS to SMS divided by BS. In the second segment, the maximum considered spectral acceleration is constant and equal to SMS divided by BS. In the third segment, the maximum considered spectral acceleration decreases and inversely proportional to the structural vibration period T, equal to SM1 divided by B1T. In the fourth segment is the lower bound for the maximum considered spectral acceleration, and it is 0.4 SMS divided by BS. No matter what the damping ratio is, the effective peak ground acceleration, EPA, is always equal to 0.4 times SMS. It has nothing to do with the damping ratio. When the structural damping ratio equal to 5%, BS equal to 1, B1 equal to 1, that means that there's no modification for SMS and SM1. And also no modification for T0 parenthesis M. Therefore, this equation reduces to the previous one, so that for the case with damping ratio 5% is just a special case for this general expression. Then back to the example, the site locates at Yuishui Township, Hualien County. The question is to find maximum considered spectral acceleration of the site for damping ratios 2%, 5%, 10%, 20%, and 40%. What's the value of SAM? From previous lecture, we have already had some information. SMS equal to 1.32. SM1 equal to 0.869, T0M equal to 0.658 seconds. And from a seismic design code table 3-2, with two damping modification factors, BS and B1, then we can construct the maximum considered spectral acceleration of the site for different damping ratios. And here's the table. In the first column is the damping ratio of the structure changes from 2% to 20%. As the damping ratio increases, the damping modification factors BS and B1 also increase. But the ratio of SMS divided by BS decreases. SM1 divided by B1 decreases. And T0M, T0 parenthesis M, increases a little bit with the damping ratio. With all this information, we can draw the curves for the maximum considered special acceleration for 2% here, 5%, 10%, 20%, and 40%. As the damping ratio increases, the damping multiplication factors also increases. BS and B1 increase. As the damping ratio increases, the special acceleration, the maximum considered special acceleration, decreases. But no matter what the damping ratio is, the effective peak ground acceleration is fixed. Therefore, the EPA does not change with the damping ratio. Then we move to maximum considered spectrum for Taipei Basin. According to the seismic design code table 2-7b, if the damping ratio of the structure is fixed to be 5%, then the maximum spectral acceleration for Taipei Basin is just a function of the structural vibration period T, and it can be determined by two parameters. One is SMS, the other is T0M. If the damping ratio is different from 5%, according to seismic design code table 3-3, the maximum considered spectral acceleration is modified by two factors. One is BS, the other is B1. Therefore, SMS is modified to be SMS divided by BS, and T0M is modified to be T0M times BS divided by B1, with T0 parenthesis M. The maximum considered spectral acceleration can be divided into four segments for Taipei Basin. In the first segment, the spectral acceleration increases from 0.4 SMS to SMS divided by BS. In the second segment, the spectral acceleration, the maximum considered spectral acceleration is constant, equal to SMS divided by BS. In the third segment, the maximum considered spectral acceleration decreases and inversely proportional to the structural vibration period T, equal to SMS times T0 parenthesis M divided by T. In the fourth segment is the lower bound for the maximum considered spectral acceleration, equal to 0.4 SMS divided by BS. And no matter what the damping ratio is, the effective peak ground acceleration always remains fixed and equal to 0.4 SMS. And here is a step-by-step procedure for the determination of spectrum with damping modification. Step 1, from damping ratio, look up table 3-1 of the seismic design code in order to get the damping modification factor for short period structures BS and for 1 second period structure B1. Therefore, from step 1, we have the damping modification factors, the two damping modification factors BS and B1. Step 2A, if the site is classified as site class 1, 2, or 3, then by using the parameters SDS, SD1, BS, and B1, then according to seismic decline code table 3-2, we can construct the design-based spectral acceleration after damping modification by using SDS, SD1, BS, B1, totally four parameters. We can specify SAD, the design basis spectral acceleration for site class 1, two or three. If the site is not classified as site class 1, 2, or 3, and it locates at Taipei Basin, then we move to step 2B from four parameters, SDS, T0D, BS, and B1. Then we can construct the design basis special acceleration for Taipei Basin according to Seismic Design Codes Table 3-3. Then we move to step 3A. If the site locates at site class 1, 2, or 3, then from four parameters, SMS, SM1, BS, and B1, then we can construct the maximum considered special acceleration for site class 1, 2, or 3, according to Seismic Design Codes Table 3-2. If the site locates at Taipei Basin, then we can also use four parameters, SMS, T0M, BS, and B1. Then we can construct the maximum considered special acceleration for Taipei Basin, according to Seismic Design Codes Table 3-3. And here's some reference, Seismic Design Codes of Building, Proposed in 2011 by the Ministry of Interior. You can download the information from this website. Videos for Lecture 1, including English and Chinese version. Lecture 2, Lecture 3, Lecture 4, Lecture 5, Lecture 6, Lecture 7, Lecture 8, and Lecture 9, Lecture 10, Lecture 11, Lecture 12, Lecture 13 and Lecture 14. This is the Chinese version. And the video here is under construction. This is the current one. And from this lecture, we talk about damping modification for spectrum. If the damping ratio is different from 5%, the design spectrum has to be modified according to two parameters. One is damping modification factor for short period structures, BS. The other is damping modification factor for 1 second period structure, B1. From these two parameters, we can modify the design basis spectral acceleration for different damping ratio, including 5% for site class 1, 2, or 3, and Taipei Basin. And with these two parameters, we can construct maximum considered spectral acceleration SAM with different damping ratio, including 5% for site class 1, 2, or 3, and Taipei Basin. As the damping ratio increases, the two modification factors, BS and B1, also increase. As the damping ratio increases, the design basis special acceleration decreases, and the maximum considered special acceleration also decreases. Therefore, the special acceleration, including design basis and maximum considered, decreases with the increase of the damping ratio. This is all for this lecture. Thank you. See you next time. Bye-bye.